And now we will learn how to refund money to tenants that are moving out. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. There's good news and bad news regarding the transaction when you pay a tenant for the money you owe them when they move out. The good news is that it's very simple to refund money to a tenant moving out. You write a check the same way that we learned. You include the tenant as both the payee and as the job, just like the way you saw it earlier in the course. The only thing to note is that the account in the lower left field is the accounts receivable account that the money's coming from. So if you're paying them back the security deposit, you would choose the security deposit account. If you were paying them back unearned rent, you would choose the unearned rent account and so on. So here's an example. On January 31, Gary in 7G moves out. First, we'll make his January invoice. Then we'll write him a check for the remainder of his deposit. So first we have to make an invoice, and the invoice we're going to make is for Gary. And of course the date is far in the future here. The date is January 31 of 2020. Here is the invoice. Now this invoice is for January's rent. So the invoice which will be applied to January's rent will go into unearned rental income because you're billing him for the normal monthly rent because he did stay during the month of January. So you would put the normal monthly rent, and we know that Gary's rent was, well, if we forget, we could always look here. Go down to Gary. Gary's rent was, I think, yeah, $800 a month. Okay, so there you go, amount $800. There you go. And then when we click save and close, that's it. Now, all we have to do is write him a refund check for his security deposit. We can look at the security deposit report and see that the remaining security deposit owed to Gary is only $600 because of this invoice that we had printed and given to him regarding the fridge. So all we have to do is open the check window, bring the date forward to January 31 of 2020, and of course we have to choose Gary as the payee and as the job. Now, we're not going to put billable. Oh, okay. Now we didn't put billable. That's okay. There were nothing there. But what we have to do, you see, is choose an account. Now, the account we're going to choose is security deposits payable. And the amount that we're going to put is $600 because that's the amount. So it's coming from, it's going into security deposits payable specifically for Gary, $600. Now, this is the check that you could put in the memo. This is your remaining security deposit. And then, of course, you can print him the report to show him why. So we click save and close. And now you can see that we owe Gary zero security deposit because we gave him a check on January 31. And this is the actual check number. Do we owe him any unearned rent? Well, if we look at the report called rent balances, we can see, if we look for Gary, down at Gary Greenstein, his unearned rent balance is zero because the January 31 invoice cancels out the January 1st payment. Now here's the bad news. If you owe the tenant both the deposit and the unearned rent, you have to write two checks, one for the unearned rent refund and one for the security deposit refund. Sorry, folks. For example, on January 31, Harry, an H8, moves out. Now, do not make his January invoice. Why? Let's just imagine the apartment was deemed a health hazard and law forbids earning rental income and Harry must go. Therefore, we're not going to make him an invoice, we're not going to acknowledge that we earned, and we're not going to charge him. Instead, we must write him two checks, one for the unearned rent and the other for the deposit. So again, we open the write a checks window and we make it January 31 of 2020, and both the payee and the customer job is Harry Houdini. Now, the amount has to be 900, but I just want to show you why. There are going to be some people out there that are going to try to write him one check for 1800, and they're going to put 900 on one row, and they're going to put 900 on the other row, and they're going to choose Harry Houdini for both rows, and they're going to put the security deposit on one row, and they're going to put the unearned income rent on the other. Now, all of you who are trying this, you are logically correct, and it should work, but it doesn't. It doesn't because if you try this, you get a message that says, you cannot use more than one AR or AP account in the same transaction. So I'm very, very sorry. Let's allow this first one to be the security deposit refund. So we'll change this to 900 and we'll simply write him another check. Let's get rid of this row as well. Be careful. So this check for 900 will decrease security deposits payable as well as the balance of Harry in that particular account. So we click, we write the check, print, whatever, save and close. And now when we open up the security deposits, we see Harry no longer has a security deposit with us because we gave him a check on January 31. You might also notice, by the way, if you open the trial balance, security deposits payable is now zero. And it's now zero because we gave back everybody's deposit in the last couple of videos. So we now have to write him a second check for the unearned rent. And you can see if you open up the rent balance, the other receivables account, you can see that this shows just what they owe for regular rent. We still owe him $900 here. So let's write him a check. And again, this time it's the same Harry Houdini in both places. Here and here, okay, and the money amount, unfortunately, for the second check is $900, and this time it's coming out of unearned rent.